slight delay off the start in this final of the women's quadruple skull for Great Britain. The Germans are away. Nice and quick in lane number three, but now the British crew starts to wind it up, led by Debbie Flood. There's Germany in lane three. The yellow bibs indicate they are current World Cup leaders in this event. Top of the picture to the left in lane one, Ukraine, the world silver medalist. New Zealand, sixth at the World Championships last year. Germany, we've just seen, and Great Britain now in lane at number four. You just see the big, powerful Debbie Flood in the stroke seat, leading that quadruple skull out towards the 250-meter mark. Great Britain in four, USA in five, Australia are in lane number six.
Great Britain have got changes in the boat. Frances Horton, who's Olympic champion, Olympic silver medalist in this boat, she's injured. She's been injured a lot in the last 18 months, and she's been in and out of boats a lot. But she was in the boat when they won the world title last year. But Melanie Wilson is a terrific substitute to have on hand. I mean, she got into the double and won one gold medal in Munich with Catherine Granger, and now she's here, really winning that seat into the bow of this boat. But then out went Frances Horton, so the other three athletes are staying in their seats.
So Germany and Great Britain qualified direct for this final, winning their respective heats. And here they are going through the 500-meter mark in this final, first and second. It's Germany first, and that marker again is wrong. The Great Britain crew are currently sitting in second place. There's Melanie Wilson to the right, Beth Rodford and Annabelle Vernon, and Debbie Flood. Really impressive. She's psychologically so hard. She sets a great rhythm to back up and sit behind there. Nice and long, a fighter right to the end. Looking all right there, Dan?
They're looking good. They're throwing up a little bit of water at the end of the stroke. You want to keep the blade part buried for as long as you possibly can to get the best momentum through the stroke. They were second fastest qualifier. Germany were the fastest qualifiers. So they've got work to do here. Germany will take confidence from being the fastest qualifier, and they've now got a good half a length. And coming up there, Australia in lane six. You can just see the bow of their boat there creeping up the British boat. But at the moment, sitting in second place, good strong length, just need to hold those blades nicely buried so that they can get the best possible power surge through to the end of the stroke.
Germany have changed position since Munich, just moving people around. Britta Oppert in the stroke seat, Olympic bronze medalist from Beijing, new combination behind her. These crews, both Great Britain and Germany, they'll be well used to racing against each other over the last couple of years. So they'll all know their styles, they'll all know the technique, when, where in the race they're about to push. And we expect Great Britain now going through the halfway mark in second place to really start to push on hard, because Great Britain have been challenged behind by United States of America and Australia on their left. New Zealand pretty quick in the white boat to their right. Out front though, Germany lead, Great Britain though still nice and relaxed though. They don't feel, when you're a length down on Germany going through the halfway mark with everyone, look at to the left there, you've got the Americans hunting down on the left. You've got in the white boat to your right, you've got New Zealand. You want to really start focusing on the boat ahead of you rather than defending the boats behind you. Again, it's just all about mindset. Chase the boat in front and let everybody behind do the working.
Well, they're staying very steady in the middle part of this race. They've obviously got a plan. They're working to their plan. They're staying very steady in the middle there. Germany, who are in this event, have dominated the event for ever since its inception. They were really only beaten two or three times in the whole of those 30 years. Now, they're back on song. They're back into the driving seat. But there are a lot of other crews that are very much very close to them. But look, they've moved on again to really a good clear bit of clear water there, with Great Britain having to make an attack now. They've got to start to wind it up, Great Britain. Otherwise, they're going to find that there's too much to do in the last 600 metres, 700 metres.
Stern pair of the British quadruple skull, enormously experienced Debbie Flood and Annabelle Vernon, Olympic silver medalists. Yeah, they know these German crew, they know what it's like to be in and amongst here. They're world champions. And now, as we head towards the 1500-meter mark, they need to remind themselves of where they stand in the world. Germany lead through 1500 with 500 to go. Great Britain in second, but New Zealand now in lane number two have taken on the challenge over America, who had it through the halfway mark. So to their right, Great Britain really have to worry, just keep that eye on New Zealand while all the time tracking down Germany and tracking they are. They've got the overlap now, and now it's all about slowly winding them in as they come down the final part of the track.
That was a good move. They've moved now, and they're moving rather well. They've come up to about half a length down on Germany. Still New Zealand pushing hard up on the far side there. But Great Britain need now to do something really special. They've got to wind it right up, and they ought to be able to get up to 38, 39 strokes a minute and really try to pull Germany back. Germany have worked very hard to be where they are in this race. But Great Britain should have that flexibility to be able to turn it up. But already Germany beginning to move up now. They've gone up to 38 strokes a minute, and they are moving really quite fast.
These closing stages now, you're seeing there's Germany from Great Britain here. Bit of head breeze now coming in, so the crews will have to really think about finishing them. And Great Britain have responded to the challenge from New Zealand up in lane number two and continue now to put the pressure, pile the pressure on Germany. And now every single stroke, the British are starting to move. They've got about 150 meters, a little over 15 strokes. You can count them in here. Surely Germany have done enough to hold off the challenge. The Germans now coming up to the line. The British continue to wind the rate up, but it'll be gold for Germany and silver for Great Britain. Both crews moving away from New Zealand, and New Zealand coming through in the bronze medal position. They had to go down in the British crew. The exhaustion is evident. They really had to work hard in that last 500 meters, gave away perhaps a little bit too much to Germany in the early stages.
In the middle of the race, they did indeed. They were very steady, very solid, and they let Germany just slip that little bit. They've got a substitute in the boat, and that obviously has an effect on the boat.